In this video, I will show you how you can create this amazing fluted or frosted glass effect inside Unreal Engine with realistic light refractions. We'll create flexible materials so you can use any possible pattern variations like lines, waves, or squares to make super realistic glass. Fluted, ripped, or frosted glass is commonly used in many places in real life. It may be used in doors, windows, and also in many other possible scenarios from factories to bathrooms. I found this effect in many games. As an example, here in Portal 2, they have these observation rooms. Or like here on Mirror's Edge, something like an industrial window. What makes this glass especially interesting is the refraction effect, which is basically distorting the image, and you can easily implement this effect inside Unreal Engine. We'll see the ways you can create the texture to drive the distortion and refraction, how to set up the material inside Unreal Engine, and how to combine different parameters to achieve any result you need. To create this effect, we'll need to consider three basic components. Special normal map texture that will drive the distortion effect, the material itself with a few advanced parameters to create refractions, and the mesh with a few key features. I'm using Unreal Engine 5.1. We're also gonna use Lumen for reflections, but you won't need the RTX graphics card to create this effect, so don't worry about that. Let's start with the normal map texture that will drive the image distortion. There are several ways you can create these textures. You can generate them using Adobe Substance 3D Designer or Substance 3D Painter for instance. You can bake these details from high poly to low poly mesh and then use this texture you created. You can also generate normal map like this inside Unreal Engine, but since this will significantly impact your performance, I found that the first two methods are the most efficient in this case. So I just created a simple plane with a few high poly meshes with the lines, squares and waves. And then, using Adobe Substance 3D Painter, I baked these details into normal map texture. I think it will be great if you can follow along this tutorial, so I'll put the link down in the description of this video where you can download these textures I created and play around with them. Let's now switch to Unreal Engine. I'll go to Project Settings, scroll down to Rendering tab. My dynamic global illumination method is set to Lumen, and the reflection method is set to Lumen as well. High quality translucency reflection is on, software ray tracing mode is detail tracing, also ray lighting mode is set to heat lighting for reflections. If you have an RTX graphics card, you also might want to check the support hardware ray tracing and use hardware ray tracing when available. But you don't necessarily need the RTX graphics card, because you can create this effect without ray tracing. Inside my level, I also have a post-process volume. The lumen reflection quality here is set to the value of 2, high quality translucency is ticked, and ray lighting mode is set to heat lighting for reflections. So here I have three normal maps that I created. Let's create a new material. I'll name it m_fluted glass. And double click on it to jump in the material editor. I'll make the window full screen. We have to change a few things in the material settings. Select the main material node and set the blend mode to translucent. With that done, we now have an opacity input in our material. Then scroll down to translucency section and under the lighting mode switch it to surface translucent volume. This will turn back the specular, roughness and metallic inputs, as well as the normal input. Let's add basic parameters to our material. I will add a constant 3 vector by left mouse clicking while pressing number 3 on my keyboard. I'll leave it in black color. Then right click and convert this node to parameter. I'm going to name it base color and connect this node with the base color input. With the left click and S pressed, add a scalar parameter. The first will be specular. I'll set the default value to 0.5. Next, add roughness. I'll leave the default value here as 0. Then let's add another parameter for the opacity. I want the default value here to be 0.3 and connect it with the opacity input. So, we now have a simple glass material. I like to keep things organized, so I'll select this node and press C to add a comment. And call it basics. It's time to add normal map to give our glass its unique shape. I'll open my content browser and drag and drop my normal map texture into the material editor. In order to be able to change this map anytime later, let's convert it to parameter and name it normal map. And also add a comment with the exact name. Now I have some normal map information and I want to have control over the tiling and rotation of my texture. Let's add texture coordinate node, here it is, and also add a scalar parameter and name it tiling. I set the default value of tiling to 1, add multiply node and connect them together. And now we need to add a rotation. We'll use a node called custom rotator. It has rotation center and rotation angle inputs. By pressing number 1 and left clicking, add a constant for the value of 1 and connect it with rotation center. Let's then add another scalar parameter and name it rotation angle. We want to be able to set our angle in degrees, but as you can see, the rotation angle in custom rotating node is the value between 0 to 1, So how do we get it? It's pretty simple. We just need to add a divide node and divide our value by 360. And connect it with the rotation angle input and with the UVs input. So we have the basic functionality for our UVs, and let's add a comment for this as well. I also want to control the intensity of my normal map, because I can get more accurate results for my glass. It's also pretty easy to do. Let's add another scalar parameter and name it normal intensity. I'll set the value here to 1 as a default. We need to add a multiply node and connect it with the red channel. And with our scalar parameter. Duplicate this multiply node by pressing Ctrl D and do the same for the green channel. Now we have to connect these nodes together. Let's use an append vector node and connect these two multiplies together. Duplicate this append node and connect it with the blue channel like that to get our normal information back in place. Then connect the last append node with a normal input and also add a comment to make things clear. Normal intensity, like that. Let's now see what we have at this point. I'll minimize the window, go into my content browser, right-click on my material and choose Create Material Instance. I'll give it a name mi_fluidglass_lines. I also go into select my window mesh, open the static mesh editor and change the material to the material instance I just created. Let's open our material instance, make the viewport full screen. Here we can adjust the tiling a little bit. I will set this value to 20. And as you can see, we didn't get the result we wanted. Even though we've added a normal map, we can still clearly see what's behind the glass, and we don't have any distortion. And here is the main trick to this material I wanted to show you. When light passes from one surface to another, for instance from air to water, the direction that light is traveling is changing, and it's called refraction. And the refraction is what makes glass look like that when it has specific shapes. And you can also implement this inside Unreal Engine. So we need to implement the refraction to our glass material in order to get our image distorted in a realistic way. Let's come back to our master material. Let me maximize the window. And as you can see, we have a specific input here for refraction. Here we have to enter something called index of refraction, or IOR. IOR is an optical measurement that describes the extent to which light is bent or refracted when it enters a particular material such as glass or water. Each material in real life has its own unique index of refraction. You can find commonly known IOR for many materials on the internet. You can also use Unreal Engine documentation. As you can see, the IOR of glass is 1.52, and the IOR of air is 1. And we need to simulate this in our material. Let's add a constant. That will be the IOR for the air itself, with the value of 1, because we are looking from the air through the glass. Let's also add one scalar parameter. That will be IOR for the glass specifically. I'll set the value to 1.52. So we need to find the way of blending these two IOR values, and here is how to do this. The light does not refract as much light when viewed straight on, but produces noticeable refraction at glancing angles. To recreate this inside Unreal Engine, we'll need a specific node called Fresnel. Let's add this node to our node graph. To show how it works, I'll right-click and select Start Preview Node. To better understand how it works, we can change the preview mesh to plane. As we look almost parallel to the plane, it gets lighter, and when we look perpendicular, it gets darker. Let's switch it back to sphere. We have a few inputs here. An exponent in value in this node, which is basically used as follow for the Fresnel effect. The default value here is 5. The value of 1 will look like this, for instance. The value of 10 will look like this. I'll return it to 5 and add another scalar parameter with the name Fresnel falloff. And send this to 5 as well and connect it with the Fresnel node. We also have Bayes reflect fraction in. I'm not going to change this value as well as normal input. So the Fresnel node will help us to determine when to use a specific IOR values, when to use the IOR of air and when to use the IOR of glass. Let me stop preview node. To combine IOR values, I'll add linear interpolate node by searching lerp. This node will use the Fresnel node as an alpha to determine when to use the IOR of glass. Let's connect our values with the A and B inputs and Fresnel node with the alpha. Position it here and connect the lerp node with the refraction input. I also going to add a comment and name it refraction. We finally have our glass material and now we can hit save to compile it. Let's open our material instance. We can already see the changes in the viewport, but let me change some new values to achieve the result we wanted. We can play with the Fresnel falloff. And maybe set it to something like 1. And we immediately get our image distorted as we want it. You can also try to change the IOR values to achieve different results. I'm going to leave it at default settings. We can also use normal intensity to control how strongly it affects to our glass. I can decrease this value just to get a little bit of distortion and vice versa. We can also rotate our texture by 90 degrees to get completely different glass. And this material now is so flexible that you can change the glass texture anytime. You can click to this checkbox. We can now open the content browser and select different normal map, like these waves, and drag and drop it into the texture input. I'll change Fresnel falloff to 1. Let's also try these squares. And maybe change the tiling to 50. And also rotate this texture by 45 degrees. And now we have this absolutely beautiful glass material. I need to mention one more thing you have to consider, and this is the mesh you're using. My current window has some thickness, and I don't use two-sided material. If you are using one-sided plane as a window glass, you'll need to check in the material settings two-sided, to be able to see the glass from the other side. But be aware that the normal map on the other side will be inverted. We also can use this technique to create noisy frosted glass like this one. You just need to create any noise texture and convert it to normal map using Substance 3D Painter, for instance, like I did. What's even cooler is that because we are using simple patterns like lines, rectangles and waves, we don't need large textures. In fact, if I open my texture, you can see that the original size of this texture is 4096 pixels, which is huge for this type of pattern. But the maximum texture size is set to 256 pixels, and it still looks great, because we only using the normal information to drive image distortion, and we also use large number of texture tiling. I hope this tutorial will help you to create your projects even better with this type of glass. If this video helps you, please give it a like, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more Unreal Engine content. See you in the next video!